I won the Fraternity in 1985 on the Gymnast, and I won the Fraternity again in 2000 on Royal Fletch. In 1985 on the Gymnast, I was so grateful to have made the Fraternity Finals. I was just thinking that I wanted to just have a good, clean run and see what happened. I was so young at the time, and it was the first horse I'd actually trained all the way to the Fraternity by myself, so it was a very exciting time just to be part of that atmosphere. Fletch. And with Royal Fletch and training Royal Fletch, it was so magical to me because I raised him, and my partner was Kip Moncrief with the horse, and it was so great that night to be part of Kit and have her have a horse in the finals and really just have a good run. I think you, in the finals, you just have to let it build and develop, and it is what it is, and your job is to go cut the three best cows you can cut and let it fall where it is. The personality of the Gymnast was, he was a wild and crazy guy, just very, very hot, took a lot of riding, took a lot of time, and I don't know if in today's day and age I'd have the time to do it, but he was a special horse and taught me probably more than I taught him. With Royal Fletch, he was very easy. He was one of the sweetest, kindest horses I've ever been around. And he was just, in the summer of his three-year-old year, I probably worked him once a week. He just didn't need much, and then we finished up, and he was just a wonderful horse to be a part of and be around. Harlan Radomski sent me the Gymnast at the end of his two-year-old year. I'd met him up in Washington at some cuttings. I'm from California, and he just called me and said, "Hey, I'd like you to train this horse." And I said, "Oh, I'd love to do it. I'd love to try it." So that's how I did it. And with Royal Fletch, I owned Royal Blue Dooley, and one of my all-time most favorite horses is J-Bar Fletch, and I thought, you know, that would be such a great deal if we could breed those two together. And Kit, she was such a great customer of mine and a friend of mine for so long that I asked her if she wanted to be part of that, and she did, and so there we are. Well, the first time I won it, I won a truck, so I didn't have to do that, so that was great. In the second Fraternity I won, I tried to save it on that time. When I was the first time, I was kind of foolish with the money, and the second time I tried to be a lot more smart about it. I think because the competition's the best of the best. I think you work so long for those aged events, and you know when you go there that if you're fortunate enough to win one of those, that you have gotten your horse prepared and you've shown against your peers, against the best of the best, best horses, best cows, best facility, best place to show. It's magical. I think the toughest part about showing at the Fraternity is not to get nerved up, is to keep it the same, that whatever got you there is to do the same thing. Don't change your routine. Keep it balanced. Work your horse the same. Don't get caught up in winning. Just keep it steady. Well, I don't know if it's good or bad, because the first time I won it made me convinced that I wanted to be a horse trainer. I'm just kidding about that. I love what I do, and it's a way of life. The second time, it enabled me to buy the place, to partner with a place on a ranch and buy it with another person, with Zoe Compton. So it changed my life in that regard. You know, one of the all-time greatest Fraternity runs that I think still stands today is Winston Hansma on C.D. Olina. I think that's was probably the benchmark for straight, correct, three cows, middle of the pen, and I think that standard still rings true today. When I first saw the Fraternity, was actually the first one I saw was in 1979, right before I went to work for Larry Reeder. And the horses nowadays, solid doesn't mean what it used to. I think all the horses, there's so many great trainers nowadays, and I think that all the horses that get there are pretty much solid. And back when I first started, you see a lot of horses would quit or were immature acting, and you just don't see much of that anymore. I think the competition is so level now, it's really about who's got the best horses.
Kathy, tell us a little bit about this horse. I understand he's one of Doc Bar Jim's get.
Yes, he's out of a black gold Zan mare. I've had him since his early three-year-old year, and I think he's a terrific colt. I've had high hopes for him all year long, and I'm just glad to be here in the finals.
He was almost down on the ground last night out there in the semis. What'd that feel like?
It's a wonderful feeling. He's felt like that all year long, and I just think he's a terrific horse. He's the best horse I've ever trained or ridden, and I just hope I get him showed well tonight.
The Gymnast. The Gymnast is owned by Harlan Radomski of Ellenburg, Washington, and shown by Kathy Dawn.
Kathy Dawn. She's been a former Futurity champion. She knows what it's like to ride down there, riding Royal Fletch.
Well, now, Royal Fletch, talking about your breeding, Royal Fletch is by, look at this cow, she's really working. Royal Fletch is by the great horse, J-Bar Fletch, who was a world champion open horse and a world champion non-pro horse, and out of a dual pet mare that's out of that great producing mare, Royal Blue Boom. So you talk about breeding, this horse is carrying the bloodline.
You know, we talked to Kathy earlier in the week. She said she had literally put everything on hold so that she could buy the mother. She felt that confident with crossing this with J-Bar Fletch. I even had a chance to ask her about the draw.
You know what? Gary Belafonte won this Futurity last in the first bunch, which everybody says is the worst draw. So I don't think the draw really matters. I think when it's going to work for you, it unfolds, and you can't help it. You can't stop the momentum, and you can't create it. It just happens.
Well, she's right about that. Look at this. It's happening for her.
Boy.
Wow.
Chubby, did you mention that she's won a little over $2 million
wow.
in lifetime earnings?
She's
That's a lot of money.
It. She's going to add to it right here. Man, she mentioned earlier in that first little insert that she had there about picking the right cows. She said having two or three, she's already had two. If she can finish this with three, I believe she's going to get fair. Look at this. Everything's in the middle.
Well, her face is so intense. She knows she's putting a run together.
She's as good as there is about picking good cattle, too, Kathy Dawn. Look at this horse.
You know, this horse reminds me of the great J.R. Fletch.
I'm
He's
telling
a
you,
lot
looks
like
a
his
lot
daddy.
Like him.
I'm worried about the score here.
I tell you what, that was a sensational run. I don't know if I've ever seen a better run in this Coliseum.
I don't think so either. We've talked about the field of these
what
horses.
They do here?
229.
Oh,
you've just seen a record book right there, Chubby.
What was the previous high score?
1997, Some Kind of Memories, and Mike Mowry at 226.
Wow.
She just set a record.
Way to go, Kathy Dunn.
Oh, boy. Congratulations to Kathy.
Welcome back to the NCHA Fraternity, where we've seen one of the most exciting finals ever. And here's Shelley with our champion.
History in the making right here at the Fraternity in the Open Finals, a score of 229. That has never happened. But tonight, Kathy Don did just that with Royal Fletch, and you did it in 1985. Does it feel a little different?
The first time, you can't ever look back over the first time. The first time was unbelievable on a horse that one of the first horses I'd ever trained. But this is so special to me because I bought his mare. I went in debt up past my eyeballs and paid $67,000 for him, borrowed the money, and raised this colt by what I think is the greatest horse in the world, J-Bar Fletch. And it's so special to me. And Kit Moncrief, who's been such a great supporter of me for so many years, we partnered up on this deal, and it's just a great thing for her and a great thing for me. And he's a fabulous horse and been fabulous to train from the beginning.
Kathy Don, congratulations. That's your Open champion.